hardest thing about being in Iraq? Being over there. The hardest thing about being in Iraq is being in Iraq. I mean, we fighting people that believe in something. If they believe that when they die, they're gonna go, you know, 18 virgins, all that stuff. You know what I'm saying? They believe that. So how you gonna kill? How you gonna try to take over a land when people believe in something? It's like, you Christian, Baptist, Jewish, whatever. You know, you believe in your religion. So how you gonna... Look, this is a religious war. You know what I'm saying? You can't change these people. You can't change their mind. Unless you're gonna just, you know, throw a nuclear bomb in Iraq to annihilate everybody. Because they're gonna keep coming. The women, the kids, all of that, all of them. You know, I'm gonna tell you one story. And then, you know, after that, you know exactly how it was, you know, on an everyday basis. One day we was driving, right? All right, you know, we was driving and shit. In one of the tanks, it flipped over in the ditch, so we all had to stop. You understand? Pool guard, secure the area. And we the fuelers, so we had to stay in the middle while the Bradleys and the tanks, they secure everything. So everything's secure and blah, blah, blah. You know, I'm sitting in my truck, and the first thing you see is, you know, a crowd of people. Now, they was just standing around and waiting. So the people in the tanks, they get paranoid. You know, they tell the people in the crowd, you know, back up, back up. All right. Okay, you know, and there was this lady who started walking out of nowhere. And you know what I'm saying? She was carrying something in her arms. And she was walking real slow. So, you know, and this lady was closer to my truck, you know what I'm saying? She came out of nowhere. So, you know, the people in the tanks, they telling her to stop. You know, I'm sitting there with my M16, you know what I'm saying? Saying in Iraqi, blah, 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 whatever. But no, she didn't want to stop. She keeps walking. Now, nobody knew if it was a bomb she's straddling. So, shots was fired. The lady falls and, you know what I'm saying, whatever was in her arms falls and starts rolling. Now, nobody knew what it was until they seen the hand of a baby come up and start crying. And everybody was just like, wow. You know, lady got shot in the head by mistake. But, you know, soldiers, they get paranoid. They don't know if it's a bomb. They don't want to get too close to it, too close to her. That's what I'm saying, you know, like, it was a mistake, you know, like, it wasn't my fault. Like, I ain't no baby. You know, I didn't want to be in the middle. You know, so the baby lying there, you know, I try to walk. You know, like it's a baby, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm sitting there frozen, you know, like, damn, you know, like, I don't know what to do. So the first step I take to go pick up this baby, right? The minute I take a step to go pick up this baby, another convoy zooms by and runs over the baby. And the baby was just, like, tangled up and rolling. The baby's head was rolling in one direction. The body was just, like, rolling in another. Now ask me how my day was on an everyday basis in Iraq. Baby was just like tangled up and rolling, and it was truck after truck after truck after truck running that baby over. It was like a convoy of trucks and tanks until you just... Now that was sick. you think them dreams don't you think them nightmares don't haunt me? Shit, every day. That shit haunts me every fucking day of my life. You know what I'm saying? I can't make it stop. You know what I do to make it stop? Shoot. Drinking. You know what I'm saying? I smoke me a blunt. And then I drink some more. You know what I'm saying? I self-medicate myself. And then I go take the medication that the VA gave me, and I'm knocked out. You know what I'm saying? That's how I go to sleep every day. You know, I go to sleep crying. You know, I sleep and think, you know, like, damn, for what? You know, I try and imagine the guys that came back with missing limbs and everything like that. You know, try and imagine what they're going through. I mean, you may see them laughing, but imagine what they're going through inside, you know, because they gave up a limb. You know what I'm saying? I gave up my soul. You know what I'm saying? I gave up my state of, you know, the way I think. I came back in amputee, but you can't see my amputation. You feel me? My amputation is up here. Nobody can give that back to me. Can't nobody give me a prosthetic mind or whatever? All I can do is just, you know, sit here, live day by day, and wonder if I'm going to die today. You know, twice. I've tried to commit suicide, you know, twice. You know, I put a gun to my head, and I pulled the trigger, you know what I'm saying? Come on, man. I was living out my car, you know. I couldn't provide for my family, you know. Everybody would deny me for everything. What I had to live for. You joined the military so that you can have a stable life for your family, so that you can support your family. You know, so I was like, okay, you know, I started thinking, I was like, you know, okay, us soldiers, we out there, you know, killing people, you know what I'm saying, killing people, doing shit that we ain't want to do for what? For these ingrates. You know what I'm saying? For these motherfuckers walking, drinking their lattes every morning, going to work. They don't give a damn that there's people's kids out there, there's people's fathers out there. You know, fathers out there fighting so that they can go about their normal day. And this is the thanks that we get? Saying that we don't care? Come on, man. That shit don't even make no sense. I didn't fight for this. You know, I didn't fight to come back to this. I expected to come back as the hero. Not the zero. About to turn 26, and you want to know what I'm gonna do for my birthday? I'm gonna sit in here and get drunk. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna sit in here and I'm gonna get drunk. You know, because if I go out, you know, something might happen to me. You know what I'm saying? I'm scared to go out. You know, I'm scared to take the train. You know, I can't be around too many people. You know, and I was never the person to be complaining, you know, like, oh, you know, this country ain't shit. You know, what's the country doing for me? But you would think that if you do a lot for this country, you know what I'm saying? You put your life on the line for this country, don't you think that you deserve something? I hear shit in my head every day. Kids crying, bombs going off. Like that. It's like, leave one war, start another. You know what I'm saying? I finished the physical war.
See, to live.
Now I'm in the mental war.
To suffer. To survive, well, that's to find meaning in the suffering.
Hey, I'm slipping, falling. Can't get up, hey, I'm slipping, I'm falling. I can't get up, hey, I'm slipping, I'm falling. I got to get up, get back on my feet so I can tear. Hey, I'm slipping, I'm falling. I can't get up, hey, I'm slipping, I'm falling. I can't get up, hey, I'm slipping, I'm falling. I got to get up, get back on my feet so I can tear.